Well, for the first time ever, I'm going to try out this new game called Divinity Original Sin. I think a couple days ago when I was streaming Baldur's Gate 2, one of my viewers suggested I try this game out too. But I'm kind of pressed for time. I don't really have a whole lot of time to work with because, believe it or not, I got laundry I got to do, and that's going to be an all-morning project. So I thought I'd just come on here just long enough to... Hang on, I already messed it up. I might have to bring in my cell phone here. Hold on. I'm in the middle of setting up right now. Come on, turn on, hunk of junk. Okay, but like I was saying, this is my very first time playing this game, and I guess I'll go ahead and put on these crummy things. And I believe this game is controller compatible. Come on, up we go. Options. Man, what the hell? Unless I'm wrong, I can see one drawback with this game already. You can either use a controller or a mouse and keyboard, but not both at the same time. Nope. So, looks like you can quick save on here. I did see a YouTube video of this recently. It's supposed to give you an option of... I also need to check the in-game volume on this. If it's too loud, I'm probably gonna have to turn it down. Whoops. And something else I screwed up on. Hold on. I gotta get my chat box in my on my PC. I gotta pop it out. So let me do this. Come on, pop out. There's about a 5 second delay, but it works. Alright, games, so. Yes, disable that. Thing of it is I want both controller and mouse and keyboard. And it looks to me like this game seems to think I'm playing on an Xbox. I'll just leave everything at 70. All right, and it looks like this game's a little bit of a resource hog, but not that much. So what this basically means is, hey. So what this means is I'm gonna have to kill the idle game that I was playing. All that. Okay, so it recognizes it. I wish you would tell me what the difficulty is. That don't explain much. I really don't know what the difference is between these. I'll tell you what. Let me pull up the wiki. See if it can give me a better explanation of what the difficulties mean. So I'm on the browser right now. There it is. Extra life. If this is gonna give me that anti-ad blocker ad, I'm leaving immediately. Block 'em. Where's trying to find difficulty? Ain't going on this kind of wiki. There we go. That's the one I'm looking for. Oh, this is on the original one. Because, like I said, the tooltips in-game don't really explain much. It just says easy, normal, and hard. Not what I'm looking for. Here we go. So it looks like classic is probably what I'm looking for. Okay, so auto mode's kind of a hardcore mode. The user only has one save slot, so every time they save, quick save, auto save, the save game is overwritten. If a character dies, the game auto saves. Going with that one. Hell yeah. That's a hardcore mode. And Yes, a long access, Mr. Firewall. Oh, I see. I had to hold down the button. Whoops. Okay, so I'm guessing when they say origin, they're meaning races. And I'd also like to think that you can also select your gender too. Oh, here we are, custom. Origin, custom. Health. Okay, just pick a human. I wish I knew what these did. I knew what those did. On human. Keep that. Oh, hell yeah, I'll keep that. Damn. Now, can I wear glasses too? Cool. I'll take it. That's a unique one. Water damage. Air damage. Earth damage. Dark damage. So, these are just gonna be, stat buffs. So it's got the dodging one, huh? I know it, in the Dungeons and Dragons universe, it's the single weapon. The single weapon is the one that gives you the, armor class bonus. NPC sight cones. That's pretty interesting. Cool. I'm more into the lockpicking part than I am the pickpocketing. gain 2 action points immediately, but lose 2 action points next turn. Okay, so now backlash. Now I'm guessing if this game here is anything like Baldur's Gate, you have to be both in stealth mode and behind the target. I don't know if it works like this. I hope it doesn't. I hope that all you have to be is behind the target. Alright. Oh, here we go. I kind of like this little feature too. You can't just push the button, you have to hold it down to show your full commitment. Nice. What was that one? Oh, yes. So I haven't actually gotten into the game itself yet, but so far I'm kind of liking it. But in case you didn't see the Twitch description, I'm probably only going to be on maybe another hour or so. Yeah, because I got a bunch of morning shit I got to get taken care of. Lone Wolf, yeah. This is the one I'm wanting. I'm gonna try to work this guy the same way I work my thief in Baldur's Gate. He's just gonna be one solo guy. But I kinda upped the stakes on this one big time. I chose a tactician, honor. Like he could only have like one save file. Morning person. And if I'm guessing right, attacks of opportunity basically means any enemy that just merely passes by you, you get a free attack on them. Oh, and if they have no weapons equipped, you'll also get a free attack of opportunity on them as well. That's an interesting one. But melee opponents find you less attractive in combat. They're more likely to avoid you? Okay, I'm guessing that's what that means. Okay, unstable. Walk it off. Walk it off. So, I think I have what I want there. Ingenious. And apparently I can't get rid of these. This is something else I kind of like too. The only game I can think of where you just simply pressing the button ain't enough. You gotta show you're fully committed. You have to actually hold down the button. Missouri. No, he's a rogue. Now that I think about it. Maybe I should look at the other classes too, like a Shadow Blade. car's polymorph. Turn on the... Macaw! Don't I already have that? No, he doesn't. I figured if I'm choosing Rogue, he would have already had stealth. Okay, that's odd. Does not break invisibility or sneaking. Okay, so I'm guessing Wayfarer is gonna be a ranged guy. Not a magic user. Could be a cleric. Okay. Now that I think about it, he looks almost like Ming the Merciless. Okay, here you go. This is where you change the gender. Look like Mongolian robot.
Greet the Reaper for me.
Greet the Reaper for me.
Try again. Try again. Better luck next time.
Almost got me that time.
Ha! Nice try.
Try again.
Greet the Reaper for me.
Glory is mine!
Inquisitor. Target character consumes blood, surfaces around them, restoring vitality. Jay. No, he's a caster. Metamorph? I kind of recognize some of them. No, he ain't no ranger. He's a melee guy. Now, when I looked at him, grants you the power. It doesn't break invisibility or sneaking, so I'm guessing a rogue does have it. I'll just go with Rogue. I accidentally reset everything. So let's. Yeah, Lone Wolf. So Scholar and Outlaw Instruments. I guess I'll just pick cello, but it's the closest thing I can find to an upright bass. Mainly because I don't really care for the other two instruments. I'm more of a bass and drums guy, not a guitarist.
It all happened like I knew it would.
Damn.
A single drop of source magic.
Pretty cool graphics. And best of all, let's not use it up all my resources.
Like flies to honey, the monsters swarmed. The rabble panicked. The carnage began. And the magisters pointed their fingers at me. Just as I'd planned. I was shackled and collared and sent to Fort Joy.
Like I said, I'm liking it. And best of all, it's not sucking off all of my resources.
But instead, I became part of their story.
Still a bit groggy, are we? Don't worry. The sedative will wear off soon enough. Easy now. No need to hurry. Get your bearings and report to me upstairs.
Oh. Hey, Skull. Just trying out a new game.
So it wasn't a dream.
Oh, cool. Your main character talks. That's rare. Okay, wasn't there an area in here where you could move UI components around? Clarion modifications. But one drawback I did see on this, you can either play with a mouse and keyboard or a controller, but not both. I mean, unless I'm missing something on that.
Not a very chatty fellow, are you?
I think this was in reference to Mort the Skull from Planescape Torment.
Not a very chatty fellow, are you?
Okay, I gotta look at something real quick. Oh! Hey, in case you guys hadn't noticed, I do use an auto mod. If, something's censored on here, just let me know. I mean, sometimes it gets a little overzealous with the censorship on here. It'll black out, you know, worthy sentences. Like, one guy came on here, like, a week ago and was like, "My nuts itch." I mean, yeah, black that out. I mean, especially from a total stranger. I've never seen the guy before in my life. You know, but when something like that go to hell, I ain't gonna worry about something like that. But as far as swearing goes, I'm mostly tolerant of it. As long as you don't, like, try to talk like a soprano or something. Oh, kind of like that. Yeah, there's... Because what I'm trying to do is... I got a portrait here in the upper left corner.
Not a very chatty fellow, are you?
I guess it could be another drawback. This guy moves slow. Uh-oh. Gotta put all your knowledge to the test, huh? Hey, is there, can you transmog stuff in this game? only English.
Really?
Yeah, I think English is probably one of my better subjects. Yeah, it was basic English and basic math. The rest I didn't care about. So, we got a little bit of Fortnite here, huh?
Huh?
Animals? Freight? Food?
Well, at least you don't lose the items in the process. Hey, can you transmog gear in this game? If so, I'm holding on to that. Add to wares?
Shaking her fluffy coat, the sheep eyes you balefully. Her rectangular eyes like letterboxes to the void.
Can you transmog gear on here? Kind of like, transmog is the same thing as glamour in Final Fantasy XIV. Can you change the appearance of your equipment to look like something else? Okay.
Wah, wah, wah.
No, I'm guessing. the one I wanted. Wait, what happened to my sack? Okay, now let's try it. I'm big enough, sack. Oh, apparently you can. I thought you could use a sack for more inventory space. Alright, Skull. That's alright, though. I'm probably only going to be on maybe another half hour or so, too, so I got a bunch of morning stuff to take care of. Yeah. Have fun at school, buddy. Good luck. Oh, that kind of sucked. I guess that could be another little gripe with throwing stuff. There's at least one other game I've seen it happen on. I can't remember the name of it, but if you wanted to throw something, and if it was out of your throwing range, what would end up happening is he would actually run forward until he was within throwing range and then chuck it. I can't remember what game it was, but that was oftentimes very disastrous. I didn't know if there was a way to turn it off or not. It seems this game has that too. Like if I try to pick an area that's way out of my throwing range, he'll try to run forward into range and then chuck it. I'll survive not trying to break someone. Yeah, maintain your sanity, buddy. Tagging the candle holder. So I'm guessing this is for Fiorello. Selecting players. So I'm in tactical mode, so I'm guessing. So And this is most certainly a Metal Gear Solid reference, although he's using a barrel and not a box. I don't know what that is, but... Oh, that's the field of view. Okay. But, like I said, everybody, this is my very, very first time playing this game, so a good chunk of my time is just going to be spent experimenting. Toggle split screen. Okay. So that door is locked. Okay, and I gotta go up that ladder. And I'm also guessing it's not really a good idea to just pick up every single item I come across. Sorcerers. The prison island of Fort Joy awaits. Yeah, I'll bet it's joyful.
Why, you're looking a bit more chipper. Yes, looks like that collar fits you snugly enough. Nice bit of work, even if I do say so myself. too tight, I hope. The collar, I mean. Oh, not to worry. Every dog has to get used to its leash. In the meantime, you're
bit of a bitch, I'd say.
Mr. William. All passengers have to be registered in the ship's manifest, and he's the chap in charge of the logs. You'll find him on the other side of this deck, in the officers' quarters.
Oh, this is interesting. Planescape Torment had something like this too. They had like bluff, lie, truth, intimidate.
Why? Because we're at sea, of course, and have been for several days.
Index fingers pressed to her lips. She pauses a moment to give you a scrutinizing gander.
So far, I'm liking the dialogue. They even throw the narrator in here, too.
My word, you do seem...
Usually, you don't get a narrator until between chapters.
Sounds a bit too generous with that sedative. Oh, well, I'm sure you'll soon gather your wits. Most likely. Eventually. In the meantime, all you need to know is that we're en route to Fort Joy.
Joy?
A new life awaits, and if you're a particularly good boy, perhaps a cure as well. An end to Source. For good. Why, for my peace of mind, of course. Why don't you try casting one of those Source spells of yours? See what happens.
I'll probably go for it. I pretty much just started this game, so if I die, no big deal.
Currents of magic surge inside you, boiling, bursting, then breaking.
Okay, maybe not.
Only to fade back into your soul, like rain into the earth.
My, look at the concentration on your face. All will, but no result. There you have it. See? The collar's function. It neuters you of sorts. Makes you unable to cast Source. For your own peace of mind, of course. Yours and the whole world's.
Good gods, there's been a murder here.
Behind the Magister, a bloodied mass lies in a heap. Gore and limbs lie at odd angles. You can't make
I like this.
Place amid the mess.
Like I said, I'm like a game like Baldur's Gate. You only heard the narrator between chapters. So they kind of... It looks like they kind of took their cue from Bastion. Bastion's narration is kind of like this. Like, the kid's happy he found it, or... The kid's glad to be back home. You know, that kind of thing.
There's been a murder. A sorcerer was killed by one of your own. Lucky you were busy getting your collar fitted at the time, or you'd be a suspect like the rest of them. Waters is investigating. She'll figure out who did it. Always does. Aren't you enterprising? I'll let Waters tell you no herself.
Huh?
Go ahead. She with the body.
Did the murderer take him into this room?
As morbid as it might sound. Kind of looks like the bodies they use on a Path of Exile. There we go. Now let's get a more tactical view. Whoops.
Ugly sight, isn't it? Burns me up this happened under our protection. We're extremely lucky no Voidwalker can follow the source that did this.
Not sure on this one. Both of these are gonna make me sound like a douchebag.
Finn didn't see it like that. He was desperate for us to help him. Two things scared the living daylights out of him. His own shadow and his own source. We'll find out who did this. Speaking of...
She looks up at you with a mirthless smile.
I was on duty in your room when the murder happened. You were asleep the whole time. Didn't even stir. You're one of the only indisputably innocent people on the ship. Unless you can commit murder in your sleep, of course. Finn was killed by Source. If a Magister could do that, there wouldn't be a Magister. It looks more like a passenger managed to slip their collar. And the rest, well, you see the evidence in front of you. Listen, I could use someone to keep their ears open among the passengers. Sometimes they clam up in front of a uniform. Bring me a good lead, and I'll throw in a shiny gold coin for you. How about that?
Scroll back up. I forgot what she said. Ooh, no. Yeah, no snitch.
A man of principle. I get it. Wonder how you'll feel when whoever did this does it again. You let me know if you hear anything. Whoever did this is dangerous.
Oh, okay.
Hmm.
Got it. Ha-ha. Yeah.
How dare you classify this slop as food? I've seen more appetizing things coming out of plague-stricken pigs.
There's nothing else I can make, Your Majesty. Turnips and water are all I was given.
Unacceptable. I've never dined on anything less than a dozen-course dinner, and I don't intend to do away with the custom.
Well, there has been a murder, Your Majesty. Maybe that has the Magister's more concern than your appetite.
Don't you get saucy with me when you clearly don't know the first thing about sauce.
Whoop. Wrong way.
Thought you'd end up a prison guard, Vic.
That right? I always knew you'd turn out rotten, Ben Mest. Your kind always hung closest to our divine, wolves around a campfire.
It's a register, sir. Good, good. Magister Williams is just about done with the last passenger. You faring okay so far? Glad to hear it. You head on in now. Williams will get you shorted fast.
Standing at the center of the room, you spot a sorcerer haughtily eyeing a pair of nervous-looking magistrates. They keep their crossbow trained upon her as she's being interrogated by a magistrate.
So you admit it then? You murdered that poor fella?
Yes, I did. But of course, that was only the beginning.
She turns her head and looks you straight in the eye.
There are others whose lives must end.
She sounds almost like the same girl that's the narrator in Dark Souls.
Good God, the woman's mad. You there, sorcerer, go and fetch Magister Siwan. We need to do more than collar this maniac. We need to shackle her hands and feet.
It means your journey draws to a close. Do stick around for its finale, though, because...
She reaches for her collar and simply removes it.
I'm just about to create a scene.
Subdue him, quickly! If she casts sauce, the Voidwalker will come. They'll end us all.
She smiles with wicked satisfaction.
Precisely.
Oh, loot. So I'm supposed to find a weapon while I'm here. And I saw a steel option. Say, there ain't nobody around. Yes. So from what it says here, I don't have to actually be in stealth. I just need to simply be behind the target. Okay, so alrighty, well, so far I'm liking it. But I'm gonna have to kill the game right here. Or, excuse me, I'm gonna have to kill the stream right here. I've got laundry I gotta do. I got a bunch of other morning stuff I have to get taken care of as well. But yeah, still gotta eat breakfast, etc. But I gotta grocery shop, all that stuff. So far I like it. I should be on my usual time, like 4-ish, 4:30. The way it's looking right now, it's going to be up in the air. It's either going to be Baldur's Gate, or it's going to be this game. I'm not sure which. So, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And, something else I was wanting to say. Can't remember what. Oh, well, but take care, everybody, and see you all next time.